Welcome back to the class, students. So yesterday we studied about the structure of a candle flame, about the flames and the zones of candle flame. So moving further, today the topic of discussion would be the fuels. What are basically the fuels? We have gone through the combustible substances. We know that combustible substances undergo combustion. Under this section, we are again having the topic fuels. What are basically the fuels?
See, any combustible substance which on burning produces a large amount of heat and light, that can be called as a fuel. Some commonly used fuels are wood, coal, LPG or the liquefied petroleum gas, then petrol, diesel and kerosene. Now these fuels can also be classified on the basis of their physical state. How can they be classified? See, we are having the physical states as solid, liquid and gas. So, any fuel which occurs in the solid form at the room temperature, it can be called as a solid fuel. Examples, we are having coal, wood, coke and charcoal. Next, we are having the liquid fuels. These are the fuels which occur in the liquid form at the room temperature. In the example section, we are having petrol, diesel, kerosene and the spirit. And at the last, we are having the gaseous fuels. These are the fuels which occur in the gaseous form at the room temperature. Examples include the natural gas, LPG, biogas and the coal gas.
So these are the classification of fuels based upon their physical state. What kind of physical state they are having? Whether they are solids, whether they are liquids or they are gases. Now you know what? Among all these fuels, the least polluting fuel will be the gaseous fuel. Now how we got to know this? To get to know this, we should study the characteristics of fuel. किसी भी फ्यूल को हम आइडियल कैसे बोल सकते हैं? Which fuel can be called as ideal? So, for getting to know that thing, we should study the characteristics of an ideal fuel. किस फ्यूल को हम आइडियल बोल सकते हैं? पहले हम उसकी characteristics पढ़ेंगे, फिर हम जानेंगे कि वो characteristics कोई ऐसा फ्यूल है जो सभी characteristics को follow करता हो? अगर कोई ऐसा फ्यूल है जो इन सभी characteristics को follow करता हो, then we will call that fuel as the ideal fuel. Otherwise, if there is no fuel, then no fuel can be considered as the ideal fuel. For coming to the conclusion, we should study the characteristics of the ideal fuel first. So let's study the characteristics of an ideal fuel. So here we are having the characteristics of an ideal fuel. Firstly, any fuel, it should have a large calorific value. Now, what is this calorific value? This is actually the amount of heat which is produced whenever we heat any fuel. जब भी किसी fuel को हम heat करते हैं, तो उससे कितनी amount of heat बाहर निकल रही है, that is the calorific value. Actually, we will study the calorific value of a fuel in detail also. Let me tell you what actually the calorific value is. You know what? Efficiency of a fuel is measured by its calorific value only. कोई भी fuel कितना efficient है, कितना हमारे लिए useful है, कितना ज़्यादा efficient है, वो हम लोग किससे calculate करेंगे? By knowing its calorific value. Now what exactly is this calorific value? It is defined as the amount of heat energy which is produced on complete combustion of a specific amount. This is 1 kilogram of a fuel. Whenever we burn 1 kilogram of a fuel, and it should be completely combustible. It should undergo complete combustion. Jab tak uski complete combustion nahi ho jati, we have to heat it. So whenever we heat 1 kilogram of a fuel under complete combustion, the amount of heat produced, that will be expressed as kilojoules per kg. Jo energy niklegi bahar, the heat energy which will be produced, it will be in kilojoules. And why we are using here per kg? Because we are using 1 kg of that fuel. So what is calorific value of a fuel? The calorific value of a fuel is defined as the amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of 1 kilogram of a fuel, and it is expressed in a unit which is called kilojoules per kg. Higher is the calorific value of a fuel, more will be its efficiency. Jitni zyada calorific value hogi, matlab jitna zyada heat energy produce hogi 1 kilogram of a fuel ki burning se, जितनी ज्यादा हीट प्रोड्यूस होगी उतनी ही ज्यादा कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू होगी और उतना ही ज्यादा वो फ्यूल एफिशिएंट होगा. ओके, सो फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज एनी फ्यूल व्हिच कैन बी कंसीडर्ड आइडियल, इट शुड हैव लार्ज कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू. दैट मीन्स व्हेनेवर वी बर्न इट, इट शुड रिलीज लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ हीट. देन सेकेंड थिंग, अब हीट तो वो प्रोड्यूस कर रहा है बट इट शुड बी रेडिली अवेलेबल. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि वो हीट तो प्रोड्यूस कर रहा है बट उसकी अवेलेबिलिटी ही कम है या फिर वो बहुत ज्यादा एक्सपेंसिव है. देन वी कैन नॉट कंसीडर दैट फ्यूल एज आइडियल. किसी भी फ्यूल को हम आइडियल कब बोलेंगे? जब उसकी कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ज्यादा होगी प्लस वो चीप रेट पर अवेलेबल होगा और रेडिली अवेलेबल होगा. इट शुड बी रेडिली अवेलेबल एट अ चीपर प्राइस. इजिली अवेलेबल होना चाहिए और कम प्राइस पे मिलना चाहिए. अगर ऐसा होगा कि लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ हीट तो प्रोड्यूस कर रहा है बट उसकी अवेलेबिलिटी ही नहीं है या फिर वो बहुत एक्सपेंसिव है दैट एवरीवन कैन नॉट अफोर्ड दैट फ्यूल, तब भी हम उसे आइडियल फ्यूल नहीं बोल सकते. सो इट शुड बी रेडिली अवेलेबल एंड इट शुड बी अवेलेबल एट अ चीप प्राइस. नेक्स्ट, इट शुड नॉट प्रोड्यूस दोज गैसेस विच पल्यूट द एयर. दैट मीन्स इट शुड नॉट कॉज एयर पोल्यूशन. Whichever fuel we are talking about, अगर वो air pollution करता है तो भी हम उसे ideal fuel नहीं बोलेंगे. Although it is producing large amount of heat, available भी बहुत easily है, but अगर वो बहुत ज़्यादा air pollution करेगा तो हम उसे ideal fuel कैसे कहेंगे? We cannot call it as ideal fuel. So it should not contribute much towards the air pollution. Next, जिस भी फ्यूल की हम बात कर रहे हैं, इट शुड बर्न एट अ स्लो रेट एंड इट्स कंबशन शुड बी कंट्रोलेबल. इट शुड बर्न एट अ स्लो रेट. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि मैंने जस्ट लाइट किया और वो एकदम से पूरा का पूरा बर्न होके खत्म हो गया. नो, इट शुड बर्न एट अ स्लो रेट. धीरे धीरे बर्न होना चाहिए और उसका कंबशन जो है वो कंट्रोलेबल होना चाहिए. वी शुड बी एबल टू कंट्रोल दैट कंबशन. नेक्स्ट, उसकी स्टोरेज ईजी होनी चाहिए, उसकी ट्रांसपोर्ट इजी होनी चाहिए एंड इट शुड बी इजी टू हैंडल. इजीली स्टोर कर सके हम उसे और इजीली कहीं पर अगर हमें ट्रांसपोर्टेशन करनी है उसकी, दैट शुड बी वेरी इजी. सो दीज आर बेसिकली द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एन आइडियल फ्यूल. व्हिचएवर फ्यूल इज फॉलोइंग ऑल दीज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, दैट कैन बी कंसीडर्ड एज द आइडियल फ्यूल. मोरओवर, इट शुड हैव मॉडरेट इग्निशन टेम्परेचर. नीदर इट शुड बी टू हाई नॉर इट शुड बी टू लो. ऐसा भी नहीं होना चाहिए कि उसका इग्निशन टेम्परेचर इतना कम है कि वो रूम टेम्परेचर पर पड़े पड़े कंबशन कर जाए. रूम टेम्परेचर पर ही आइडल ऐसा रखा हुआ है और वो बर्न कर जाए. इतना कम भी नहीं होना चाहिए उसका इग्निशन टेम्परेचर और इतना ज्यादा भी नहीं होना चाहिए कि वो टेम्परेचर ही अटेन करना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाए. दैट वी कैन नॉट प्रोवाइड सच एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशन टू रेज द टेम्परेचर अप टू दैट इग्निशन टेम्परेचर. So it should have a moderate ignition temperature. ना ही तो ज्यादा कम होना चाहिए और ना ही ज्यादा बहुत ज्यादा होना चाहिए. Next and the last, it should produce very small amount of residues. जब भी हम किसी फ्यूल को बर्न करते हैं लास्ट में वो कुछ रेसिड्यू छोड़ता है. किसी भी फ्यूल को अगर बर्न करते हैं, बर्न होने के बाद लास्ट में वो जो रेसिड्यू छोड़ता है, जैसे वुड को बर्न करने पे लास्ट में एशेज बचती है, that should be produced in a very small amount. Jis fuel ki hum baat kar rahe hain, agar wo ashes ya fir any other residue, it is producing in a very small amount, then we can call that fuel as the ideal fuel. Now you tell me, are we having any fuel that is following all these characteristics? Aisa koi fuel hai jo har ek characteristic ko follow karta ho? Unfortunately, we are not having any fuel that have all these qualities. ऐसा हमारे पास कोई फ्यूल है ही नहीं जो इन 7 की 7 qualities को कैरी करता हो. So no fuel can be considered as an ideal fuel. But we are having a lot of fuels जो इनमें से बहुत सारी क्वालिटीज को पोजेस करता है. हर क्वालिटी को तो कोई भी फ्यूल पोजेस नहीं करता, बट इनमें से अगर आउट ऑफ दीज सेवन अगर फोर या फाइव को पोजेस करता है या सिक्स को करता है, देन ऑल्सो वी कैन कॉल दैट फ्यूल एज अ वेरी गुड फ्यूल. आइडियल तो नहीं कह सकते, बट वी कैन कॉल इट एज अ गुड फ्यूल. ओके, so these are basically the characteristics of an ideal fuel. Here in this table, the calorific value of different fuels are also mentioned. You can check it on your own. Which fuel is having largest calorific value? You can check it here. Hydrogen is having the largest calorific value. It is having the calorific value of 150,000 kilojoules per kg. It is very high. So it can be considered as a very good fuel. After that, we are again having the CNG, LPG and biogas. These are all the gaseous fuels. These are having the calorific value in the higher range. Below them, we are having the liquid fuels. And in the least section, we are having the solid fuels. Analyzing this table, you can get to know that gaseous fuels are having highest calorific values, then liquid fuels are having the moderate calorific values, and the solid fuels, they are having somewhat low calorific value. Why they are having these low calorific values? Because they contribute a lot towards the air pollution also. The cow dung cakes, they are having 6,000 to 8,000 kilojoules per kg. This is very low value. Moreover, these release a lot of gases which are harmful for our lungs also. They can cause diseases also, and they contribute a lot towards the air pollution. So these cannot be considered as good fuel. Good fuel, we can call the gaseous fuels as the good fuel because they are having high calorific value, plus they are again readily available and they are not that much expensive. Then they contribute very less towards the air pollution, and they are easy to store and transport also, and they are not having that much high ignition temperature also, और उनसे रेसिड्यू भी बहुत कम बचता है. सो दे कैन बी कंसीडर्ड एज अ वेरी गुड फ्यूल. नाउ व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द बर्निंग ऑफ द फ्यूल्स, फ्यूल्स को किस लिए यूज कर रहे हैं हम? फॉर द बर्निंग प्रोसेस, फॉर डोमेस्टिकेशन ऑल्सो. आप घर पे भी खाना बनाते हो, गाड़ियों में यूज करते हैं. सो दीज आर ऑल बर्न. सो व्हेन वी आर बर्निंग दीज फ्यूल्स, definitely we will be having some harmful effects also. Hamari body par bhi bahut sare harmful effects ho sakte hain aur hamare environment pe bhi bahut sare harmful effects ho sakte hain. So let's discuss the harmful effects of burning these fuels.
So here we are having the harmful effects of burning these fuels. We know that carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxides of sulfur and oxides of nitrogen, also the unburned carbon particles, soot, ash, smoke, etc. These all are produced whenever the fossil fuels are burned completely or incompletely. The harmful effects of these various pollutants on our environment are also summarized here. The dust can produce various allergic reactions to the eyes and lungs. The smoke can lead to the respiratory problems. Also, the carbon monoxide, it can also lead to various respiratory problems, which can also lead to death. And also, the excess carbon dioxide produced during burning can cause greenhouse effect, and it also raises the temperature of the atmosphere. The oxides of sulfur, it can cause damage to the lungs, and they also produce acid rain, which we will discuss later, and they can also cause corrosion. Also, the oxides of nitrogen can cause lung congestion and they also produce smog, which is very harmful. Then comes the greenhouse effect. We know that the carbon dioxide is released during combustion. It can result in an increased percentage of this gas in the air. An atmosphere with excess carbon dioxide can trap more heat, and this is called the greenhouse effect. Many scientists believe that this can also result in an increase in the average temperature of the earth, which is called as the global warming. And this can lead to the melting of the polar ice, causing flooding in the low-lying coastal lands, and also the climate can change. Then comes the acid rain. What is it? The rainwater containing dissolved oxides of nitrogen and sulfur, this is called acid rain. The acid rain is very harmful to both the living and the non-living things. Some harmful effects of the acid rain are also given here. Firstly, the acid rain promotes corrosion of the metal structures. Next, it also affects the plants and the aquatic life or the marine life. That means it destroys plants and the fishes. It also leads to the loss of soil fertility, and it is highly acidic and corrosive. It also reacts with the limestone and the marbles of the historical monuments. Due to such reactions, the marble gets corroded and loses its shine. Thank you and have a good day.